Jesteśmy dziś na konferencji Polskiej Grupy Raka Płuca. Rozmawiamy z profesorem Nicolasem Girardem z Instytutu Curie w Paryżu. Profesor Girard jako jeden z niewielu klinicystów uczestniczył w badaniach klinicznych nad bispecyficznymi przeciwciałami wykorzystywanymi w terapii raka płuca.
Jak działa terapia z użyciem przeciwciał bispecyficznych w raku płuca?
If we combine the two targets in one antibody, we have actually a higher efficacy because it works on one cell with the two mechanisms, and you will have a deep inhibition of these pathways in the cancer cells, meaning that the bispecific is doing better than the two drugs separately. And this is what we see in EGFR mutated lung cancer. So this small group of patients, about 15%, I guess, in France and Poland, in Europe overall. 15% of the patient, you look at the mutation, you find this EGFR mutation. And if you treat with a bispecific EGFR MET, actually, not only you will have a deep inhibition of the EGFR, and we know that the cancer cells, they try to escape to this drug by activating MET. So here with the bispecific, we are actually avoiding the activation of MET, so anticipating the resistance mechanism. So it's a way to have a prolonged efficacy of the treatment.
Czy terapia zmienia sytuację chorych?
Here, amivantamab EGFR MET, bispecific. It's the first demonstration that a bispecific is showing a benefit, whereas the combination of the two drugs given, two oral drugs, has never shown any kind of benefit. So, and this is because the bispecific is clearly working locally, you know, on the same cancer cells, not only to inhibit the mechanism associated with the development of cancer, but also protecting against the emergence of resistance mechanisms. You know, it's like the antibiotics. When you give antibiotics, you treat a bacteria with antibiotics, but the bacteria are developing resistance, and so they are still growing when they become resistant to the antibiotic. You can give two antibiotics. You can give one antibiotic and then the other to treat the bacteria. But you can also give two antibiotics or a more potent antibiotic protecting against the emergence of resistance, and then you will treat your bacteria. Exactly the same concept.
Jak wykrywa się raka płuca?
With lung cancer screening, meaning in high-risk people, mostly smokers, heavy smokers, more than 50 years old and more than 25 years of smoking, we know that doing regular imaging, CT scanner, is actually leading to decrease the mortality related to lung cancer by 20%, which is a lot. And in the countries where lung cancer screening is implemented in this population, we see a switch towards more patients diagnosed with early stage. Right now in France, it's not implemented. It will start hopefully next year. But in the countries where lung cancer screening is implemented, the UK, Belgium, the Netherlands, the US, not Poland, but we see this switch in the epidemiology, less patients with metastatic disease, more patients with early stage.
Czy rak płuca będzie w przyszłości chorobą przewlekłą?
In some patients, especially the patients with molecular alterations such as EGFR or ALK, which is another subset of the patient, we see that the survival is quite prolonged, actually, several years, more than 4 years in the majority of these patients. So that this is true that when we see a patient just diagnosed with EGFR mutated or ALK positive lung cancer, we know that we will follow the patient for years.
Czy polski i francuski system opieki zdrowotnej różnią się w kwestii leczenia raka płuca?
You know, I'm working at Institut Curie in Paris and we have a close collaboration with Institut Curie in Warsaw actually. So we have some studies together and it was really interesting to look at how the patients are treated in both countries. Globally, the strategies are the same, you know, and this is true in Europe. Among the European countries, the access to new drugs may be different, the reimbursement, but at the end, the concepts are similar. We have common guidelines, the ESMO, the European Society Medical Oncology Guidelines, that are the guidelines that we follow for routine practice. We see that we easily combine also the treatment modalities because we discuss systemic therapies, but we know that we can combine targeted therapies, chemotherapy, immunotherapy with radiotherapy. For example, in a patient with limited number of metastases, we can apply radiotherapy to some of these lesions. And this is a work that we published with the colleagues here in Warsaw. So globally, the concepts and the way we treat the patients are similar. Then the reimbursement may be different in Poland or in France. In France, we are in challenging times and we see that some very innovative new drugs are not approved for reimbursement. And I feel that in Poland, the access to new drugs may be actually easier.